Let's prove an identity from the 1985 All-Soviet Union Mathematical Olympiad. We have the numbers 1, 2 up to 2n minus 1, 2n are divided into two disjoint sets, which the first set consists of the numbers a1, a2 up to an, order in increasing order, and the second set consists of the numbers b1, b2 up to bn, order in descending order. Then our goal is to show that no matter how you assign these 2n numbers into the two sets, you always have the sum of absolute values of a1 minus b1 plus the absolute value of a2 minus b2 all the way to the absolute value of an minus bn will be always equal to n squared. And this identity is actually called Proizvolov identity, proposed by the guy as a problem for the contest in 1985. In this video, I'll be showing you two different ways to prove this identity. So get set and let's start proving. The main observation is that ai minus bi is getting bigger when I runs from 1 to n, because the sequence of a1, a2 up to an is increasing and the other sequence b1, b2 up to bn is decreasing. So if there exists a number j such that ai minus bi is less than 0 for 1, less than or equal to I, less than or equal to j, and ai minus bi is greater than 0 for j plus 1, less than or equal to I, and less than or equal to n, then the absolute value of ai minus bi is equal to bi minus ai for I between 1 to j, and the absolute value of ai minus bi is equal to ai minus bi for I in between j plus 1 and n, just by using a definition of the absolute value. A thing that I want to point out also is that ai minus bi can never be 0, as the two sets consist of distinct numbers. Then we can first rewrite the sum of absolute values using a summation notation, where I runs from 1 to n. Then t is equal to two sums, where we have applied the observation that we have made, where the first sum is from 1 to j of bi minus ai, and the second sum is from j plus 1 to n of ai minus bi. Now I'm going to use the fact that we know the sum of all numbers a1 to an and b1 to bn, which is the sum of the integers 1 to 2n, because they are the numbers given to us. And we can rewrite the two sums as bi plus ai minus 2 times by ai for the first sum, and ai plus bi minus 2 times by bi for the second sum. Then splitting these two sums, what you will get is that the sum of ai plus bi from 1 to n by combining the two parts of the sum above, then minus 2 times the sum of ai from 1 to j, and 2 times the sum of bi from j plus 1 to n. And as we have said earlier, we know that the first sum is just adding 1 to 2n, which is 2n times by 2n plus 1 over 2, or 2n squared plus n. Now we are supposed to prove that the whole thing is n squared, which means you can check that the other two sums must add up to give a value of n times by n plus 1 over 2, which is famously known as the sum of the integers 1 to n. And since there are also n numbers being added together in the sums, we should expect the numbers to be exactly the numbers 1 to n. We can prove this by showing that a1, a2 up to aj and bj plus 1, bj plus 2 up to bn are all less than or equal to n. Focus on the number bj plus 1. It is less than bj, bj minus 1 up to bn by our definition. So it is less than j numbers. Then it is also less than aj plus 1, aj plus 2 all the way to an, which there are n minus j numbers greater than bj plus 1. So altogether, there are n distinct numbers larger than bj plus 1, which also implies that bj plus 1 must be less than or equal to n, since all the numbers are between 1 to 2n. This automatically implies that bj plus 1, bj plus 2, all the way to bn are all less than or equal to n. In a similar manner, we can show that a1, a2 up to aj are all less than or equal to n by knowing that aj is less than aj plus 1, aj plus 2, all the way to an. And it is also less than Vj, Vj minus 1, Vj minus 2, all the way to B1. This means that it is less than n numbers, so it must be less than or equal to n, which proves that A1 up to Aj are all less than or equal to n. Hence, since the n numbers A1, A2 up to Aj and Bj plus 1, Bj plus 2 up to Bn are all less than or equal to n, it must be the case that they are in fact equal to the set of numbers 1 to n. So the two sums must be equal to the sum of the numbers 1 to n, which is n times by n plus 1 over 2. And the final answer can be calculated to be n squared. Now, I have also found a pretty elegant proof from Wikipedia and also from a website, Cut the Knot. Link in the description if you want to check them out. And we will go through the details of that proof. To make our argument cleaner, let's note that the absolute value of AI minus BI can be formulated as the maximum of AI and BI minus the minimum of AI and BI, such that it is always positive. Then you can actually draw some similarity from our previous solution by saying that it suffices to prove that the set of numbers which are the maximum of AI and BI must coincide with the set of numbers n plus 1 to 2n, because n squared arises from summing up the numbers from n plus 1 to 2n, then subtracting the numbers 1 to n. So we should prove the above claim as the set contains those larger numbers. To prove this, we invoke a similar argument we used in our previous solution. That is, because all the numbers a1 to an and b1 to bn are distinct, we can show that the maximum of ai and bi must always be greater than n, which will then imply that the set of maximum will contain all numbers n plus 1 to 2n, right? So to show this, we can assume for the contrary that there exists a number k, such that the maximum of ak and bk is at most n. This means that ak, bk are both at most n, and what's important is that if we consider all the numbers a1 to ak minus 1, which are less than ak, then the numbers bk plus 1 to bn, which are less than bk, together with the numbers ak and bk, we have a total of n plus 1 numbers, but they are all at most n. This is a contradiction, as we can't have n plus 1 numbers that are at most n. So this means that such k cannot exist, and the maximum of ai and bi is indeed greater than n for I between 1 and n. Hence, since the maximums will be the numbers n plus 1 to 2n, then all the minimums will be the numbers 1 to n. So the final answer can be calculated to be n squared by adding n plus 1 to 2n and subtracting 1 to n. Hence, this proves the identity above. Now, if you have reached here, make sure to subscribe to the channel for more math videos and click the video on the screen right now to watch how I solve two hard coffin problems, and I'll see you in that video.